Right.
Dill has been keeping quite a compendium of matchup knowledge.
Yes.
Game knowledge in general.
Rob knowledge. Rob knowledge.
Look, he's got to plan some robberies.
Yeah, I mean, he's been trying to compile lists of how positive Rob is on the detail. That's obviously a big deal, as specific percentages. Nice. Wait it out.
Yes, very good bait on that one. See, the thing that gets me about this matchup, right, is that Palutena's disadvantage is not as spectacular, I would say, as Rob's. And Dill is really patient with his disadvantage.
It depends on where you are. If we're off the stage, then I would say Rob has a slightly better disadvantage. If we're above the stage, then Palutena, she definitely still has a better disadvantage than Rob above the stage.
You think so?
Yeah.
I'm not so sure.
Rob just did not hit the floor, man. Rob has a lot of trouble hitting the floor.
Yes, but here's the thing, right? I feel like Jen will have an easier time getting back to stage with Palutena because if you go out too far, warp, you're not catching that.
Yeah.
But Dill has ways to make it so that if you're trying to ledge trap him, it's a lot scarier. That nearly killed.
Yeah, I mean, no. When it comes to ledge trapping, Rob has the advantage here, for sure.
No, I mean when Rob's getting ledge trapped, because you'll see
Rob has like infinite mix-up off of ledge trap. Like he is not bad at all at getting off the ledge.
Yes.
But I'm saying more so, again, disadvantage has multiple aspects, so it's kind of tough to say that one character has a worse disadvantage than the other one. But Dill, with the snipe.
Yes.
I should like that.
You see, you don't need to worry about disadvantage when you got your dreidel with you. You gotta spin that sucker and let him go.
As someone who really dislikes non-committal edgeguards, I'm definitely a hypocrite and I love Gyro edgeguard. I love Gyro edgeguard.
Well, see, the thing is, what is the excuse with Gyro? It's because it's got a very, very predictable arc. It's reactable.
Yeah.
Granted, some characters can't answer it if they're in a specific spot. Here it comes. Down tilt. Follow-ups. So that was an interesting thing there, is that Gyro had disappeared, but he was probably counting on Gyro to be there to get a little bit more out of that. That's really good.
Side B casting out the lingering vulnerability of Jen.
Yes. Side B is fantastic.
Up says stay above me.
All right. Tries to go for the Nair there. Still fair, but chooses to back off because he doesn't want to contest against Rob too heavily. All right, hang over with Fair, hits him off with the last hit in there, which will allow him some time. All right, what's he gonna do with it? See, this is the thing, right? So he tosses the Gyro straight towards him. For people who aren't aware, if you toss Gyro, you can smash toss it straight up to completely remove it from play for about 3 seconds.
Yeah, for about 3 seconds. So that is, if you don't have Gyro play, that's what you should be doing.
Yes,
for sure.
Exactly. And there's nothing wrong with tossing it for a little bit of pressure, but chances are if you're playing against other Robs and item tosses in general, especially when like Dill, he will know what to do with it.
Yeah, he'll know how to respond. But after a really strong start from that stock from Dill, Jen brought it all the way back.
He's not all
nice. That recovery was incredible.
Speaking of that, can you see how Dill already had the up air out there? Because he was like, yeah, he's going to edgeguard me. He's going to try to go for the down air and end this now. Very nice, spacing out here. Does get the Gyro, throws it again, tries to catch it, but not used to the arc on that one. All right, actually clanks the forward air with the up air. That was the oddest clank I've ever seen.
Ooh.
All right.
Back air.
Back air. So not looking too great on here. He can still get off the ledge, but
jump. Dill loves to do that mix-up.
Yes.
Where he uppies below the stage and then jumps last second to get a fair out. So we get stage control after being ledge trapped.
Yes.
But that was super smart recognition by Jen. To get that after a lingering hitbox, wasn't going to allow him to be jumping in the spot that Dill normally likes to jump.
And still makes it out there because that thing's out for such a long time that you can still air dodge, or not air dodge, two frame.
Yeah.
Very good. All right, so now got
the you're dead!
He's dead!
Yes, I love cheese. Thank God. Yes!
That's like a fine, sharp white.
Because it's not aged at all. You just died. That's like something that came right out of the oven. It's super fresh. No aged wine, no aged cheese. Nah, that's like...
You know, you say that,
where a brownie comes right out of the oven and it's really,
yes.
Like soft and like fudgy and like...
I'm going to say...
Thank you, SSB, for the sub. I appreciate you.
But I'm going to say, I have seen, I don't think I've ever seen that setup in particular, but I've seen enough Rob early side B cheese kills off the side to know that is aging like fine. It is getting there. So.
Yeah, Nair Gyro into side B is definitely the confirm. If you have Gyro in hand, if you let Rob Z drop Gyro Nair you should take a lot of damage.
Like, yes.
If not die.
Gotcha. Okay, goes
Rob
for the follow-up.
Rob can reset that for like three loops. So at zero, he can like reset you for three loops.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
All right, does the pop up there?
I'm sure it's character dependent as well, but.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure Dill could tell you all about that.
Yeah.
I'm not sure Dill could tell you how to get to the ground, though. He's still trying to figure it out right now. Burns his air dodge, but gets back to the platform.
Yeah,
okay.
That's what I was mentioning earlier, is that Rob definitely can struggle at getting back to the stage. Oh,
catches
the
jump twice. He's got to guess. One of the
other.
No, he
back.
Can't get it.
Yeah, that's the thing. He had him without jump all the way deep in the blast zone. Palutena, while her warp is significantly better than 4, it still doesn't have as much range as some other teleport recoveries.
Yeah, it's not bad. The primary thing about it is its speed and its low recovery. That
just
killed.
Looked true on Rob, on
yes.
DI out.
Yes. Rob is quite a big boy. He's maybe not the heaviest, maybe not the biggest, maybe not the slowest, but he is quite a large boy. All right, taking it
she
back
can
off
grab
stage.
Kill them from Rob. That's not good.
Yes. Although he was at the ledge, so...
No, right. That is specifically at the ledge is where it's like more potent. Oh, no jump! Don't jump into that.
No, he could have just gone back to ledge and been okay.
Yeah.
He would have had to eat a mix-up, but it's better than eating a back air.
Yeah, Rob is one of those characters where you have to manage your disadvantage state super carefully because getting ledge trapped by Rob... Also really bad. He has really good ledge traps. Some of the best in the game.
Yes.
And nice. I like that.
Yep, good reflect. Very low commitment reflect.
Oh, no jump?
All right. Waiting him out. Tried to get him on the air dodge, but doesn't actually do it. Just goes
below.
Nice
parry. Good reaction by Jen.
Yep. All right. Explosive flame to burn the jump. Get too much out of it. Waiting it out here. He's trying not to be too crazy. Especially if he gets reversed here, this could be really bad for Jen. And he could start eating a lot of percent off stage.
Oh, nice. 34%
like he has the chance to right
no,
now.
Oh, okay. Almost got a 2-frame right down air.
Nice goes for the back air. Almost does the cross up there. So that's another trick, is that Rob with the sour spot of back air can cross up on your shield, which is a really good way to try to go for a kill confirm without making yourself too unsafe. But he misses it there. Completely dips. All right. Playing between
nice.
Him and the gyro.
The
you don't want to be there.
Jen in the corner.
Oh, he waits it out.
Good reaction by Dill there. Not overcommitting on the abandoned state.
Doesn't go for the down throw either because at this sort of percent, it's basically a mix up of how much they.
That, I want to, because there's a genius element to that. And
yes.
Jen is like, he has gyro in hand. He's going to Z drop it on my block. Mm-hmm. And Dill was like, yeah, I'm going to Z drop it, but I'm also going to click dare. Or bear, rather, and it's going to hit you right before you get out. So it was one of those situations where it was delayed just enough that Jen was like, okay, I can shield drop now.